These are cancer cells. Imperceptible to the human eye, revealed in active growth by the camera. With a single photograph, an instant of time can be isolated and preserved. With a series of photographs, movement itself can be analyzed and recorded. Eadweard Muybridge made this experiment in the 1870s using a battery of 20 cameras. The sequence, seen in order, contained the very elements of movement. It was of great interest to scientists studying animal locomotion. Another method was to record successive images on a single photographic plate. Although simpler, this had the disadvantage of superimposition. To overcome it, the French physiologist Marey conceived the idea of moving a strip of film between each exposure. With this more refined technique, he was able to record and study the corrective movements of a cat falling. These historic chronophotographs, taken some 70 years ago, were part of his researches into problems of human and animal locomotion. Here, the separate images lay side by side, but the camera could equally well be turned so that the film moved vertically in this fashion. In seeking to perfect an instrument for the scientific analysis of movement, Marey had hit upon the principle of the modern cine camera. This was the forerunner of this. True slow motion recorded by one of Marey's associates, Noguès, after the invention of cinematography. From its earliest days, the cine camera was brought to bear on things never before observed in detail. A ball bouncing on a jet of water was an early high-speed study. Ballistics demanded higher speeds. The action of a paper pellet piercing a bubble was demonstrated by Lucien Bull at 1,200 pictures a second in 1905. Krantz took 5,000 pictures a second in 1909. Chardin followed with 70,000 and filmed the fracture of glass at 200,000 pictures a second. This last study of a bullet virtually tapping against a glass plate was made in 1940 at more than 6 million pictures a second. Movement is analyzed and slowed down. Time appears to be expanded so that every kind of rapid visual event can be seen and studied. Movements too rapid for the eye to follow, or too slow to be perceived. As early as 1898, the German botanist Wilhelm Pfeffer was able to compress the growth of beans during 11 days into a few seconds. Movement is speeded up to reveal processes too slow to watch in nature. Time is accelerated to disclose the plant kingdom in dynamic growth. We can watch destruction as the dodder circles, entwines, and strangles its victim. when the dodder meets the convolvulus, the rivals lock in mortal struggle. Speeding up the processes of growth and decay, the strange world of the fungi is revealed. Crystals grow in geometrical perfection. Camera and microscope were first combined in 1895, again by Marey, to record the behavior of blood corpuscles. He was followed by Commandant, who made these studies of blood circulation at the Institut Pasteur in 1912. More recently, the time-lapse camera has been used to study the ordered complexities of cell division. At first, these new plant cells seem identical, but later they may become leaf, bark, or flower. We can follow the process of growth. Watch the fertilized egg of a rabbit as it divides and divides again to form an embryo with all its diversity of tissues, each with its own function. In a matter of seconds, we see a whole day's development of a chick embryo. Now the backbone is beginning to form. With careful manipulation of cells taken from a living organism, bone can be grown in isolation in the laboratory. Here, the time-lapse camera has been used to study growth. Here, X-ray cinematography serves to demonstrate function. The movement of a dog's leg and of the human stomach were photographed by Dr. McIntyre as early as 1897. More recently, X-rays have been combined with microscopic techniques to throw light on small, invisible movements such as these. The digestive tract of the common fly. Combined with television for extended medical examination. Here, drinking and swallowing. Combined with sound recording to demonstrate the mechanism of human speech.
Achten Sie bitte auf diese Vorgänge bei den Vokalen A, E, I, O, U.
Different techniques reveal the functioning of other mechanisms. A moving object placed before a fly and seen through the multiple lenses of its compound eye shows that it recognizes movement rather than visual detail. And where motion is too rapid for normal observation, the high-speed camera slows down the movements of the fly's wing and reveals the gyroscopic action of the tiny balancing arm just behind it. Whether it is to study this or this, the camera can reveal the elements of movement vital to understanding. Performance is studied in relation to design. The spread of droplets from an atomizing spray. the action of propellers underwater, or, in the same environment, the discharge of torpedoes from a submarine. The course taken by a single ear of wheat in a threshing machine. The vibration of a lathe during a particular cutting operation. The production of nails when the speed of a machine is increased beyond its capacity. The effect of introducing a small metallic object into the air intake of a gas turbine. Beyond the workshop and the laboratory, we have a new sight of earth and sky. The movement of a glacier during one whole year. The ephemeral flickerings of the aurora borealis. The great circle of the Earth as a rocket leaps beyond its atmosphere. Majestic movements of the heavenly bodies. This eclipse was recorded by Gomo in 1912. In 1928, W.D. Wright made this study of Jupiter and one of her moons, on the left by ultraviolet and on the right by infrared. Here, speeded up, you can see the rotation of Mars, or the Earth's shadow advancing across the surface of the Moon. In close-up, the fiery mass of the Sun seethes with activity. The solar atmosphere can normally only be seen during a total eclipse, but Leo invented the coronagraph, a kind of artificial eclipse, and with it, in 1935, made this historic record of the so-called solar prominences shooting hundreds of thousands of miles into space. The moving film captures movement in all its phases. Combined with special optical techniques, it can throw light on the invisible. Here, dark ground illumination reveals cellular activity in malignant tissue. Here, an adaptation of the interference microscope shows diseased cells in relief. Here, the Schlieren technique makes visible changes in pressure around the wing section of an aircraft. Color adds a further dimension. Here, it differentiates between areas of pressure and rarefaction. Here, between hot and cold, as water mixes in a glass trough. Using a different technique, it illuminates stress set up by a passing train in this transparent model of a railway line. Watch the invisible. See how the water beetle uses surface tension. Study hidden structures within the living cell. Penetrate darkness with infrared to observe the reflex action of the pupil of the eye. Peer down into the lungs, or pass within the abdomen. Look into the womb, and there, in the darkness, see life before birth. Constantly probing, seeking the inaccessible, revealing the invisible, the cine camera records and analyzes all that moves beneath the sun.